My name is Paula Lombardi. I live in Springfield, Pennsylvania. I'm a victim of civil court corruption. My nightmare began when I met Fred Snyder. I was introduced to him by a couple of girlfriends that didn't even know each other. He moved really fast, and before I knew it, he had asked me to marry him, and we were looking at homes in Pennsylvania. He claimed he didn't have any money for down payment for a home, so he had his home up for sale in New Jersey. He gave me a mortgage note on his New Jersey home, recorded in the Woodbury Courthouse, along with the prenuptial we had. One of his divorced lawyers, had drawn that up. I did not know Fred was married. Well, he's married for the fifth time now. I did not know he was married when I met him four times. According to the contracts, Fred was supposed to take immediate steps to sell the New Jersey property to reimburse me half the down payment for the Springfield home. Well, once he got his name on the deed, he bolted. He never paid his half the down payment. A few years later, I kept asking him to sign a quitclaim deed off the Pennsylvania home, and I would just forget about the note where he owed me half the down payment. Gave him a quitclaim deed about three times. He would take it and say, I'll sign it and give it back. He never did. A few years later, a sheriff came to my door. He was suing me for $44,000. He testified at the trial that he never financially contributed to the Pennsylvania home, and he breached our contracts. But the judge completely ignored our legal contracts and awarded him $19,000. I figured, well, maybe he was using the note that he gave me for $20,000 on his home in New Jersey as if he put into the Springfield home. But that wasn't the case. I appealed the decision, and every attorney would take my money and then tell me to give up the fix was in. So finally, a couple years later, two and a half years later, after that original trial, the judge, Judge Pagano, actually amended his original order to now take away that note that Fred gave me for half the down payment of the Springfield home. Oh, no, you don't. I went to lawyer after lawyer. They took my money up front, kept telling me the same thing. You might as well give up. The fix is in. The fix is in. I didn't know what that meant. So I, after all my research and everything, I appealed myself to Superior Court, and I won on my own. They vacated Judge Pagano's amended order. I still had the note. Now I still had the note. He could never sell that house in New Jersey without giving me half the down payment for the Springfield, Pennsylvania home. Well, about 3 weeks later, his lawyer wouldn't give up. He was very contumacious and I can't even talk about James Kelly, because I don't want to say anything bad about anybody really, but he's bad. He went back to the lower court, which, if anybody knows what res judicata means, it means it's already been judged in the higher court. You cannot go back to the lower court and try the same parties, the same issue, in the same court again. Well, it didn't stop James Kelly. He did it anyway. I filed an objection to it, and I won. Judge Harry Bradley, a senior judge in the lower Delaware County, in the Delaware County Court, he denied it. You can't do this. You still owe her. And besides, it's been judged in the Superior Court. They waited until Judge Bradley died, in 2008. There was nothing new filed, no new evidence to support any kind of order. I get a letter that yet another judge in Delaware County wanted me to show up in court. Why another judge? Because at this point, I filed a lawsuit for torturous interference with contractual agreements and included Judge George Pagano and James Kelly in it. That got dismissed by a visiting judge, Judge Quigley from Harrisburg. Well, let me see, where do I go from here? My case has been going on since 1999, so I'm trying to condense it. So when he died, no new complaint was filed, like I said, no evidence to support any kind of judgment or anything. Judge James Proud files an order, a declaratory judgment, to now take my note away from me anyway. No complaint. I have my tapes with me from the court. You could hear me say, Your Honor, there's no complaint in the record. There's no proof of payment. Ask him. Nothing. A week later, I get that judgment that I have to discharge the note that he owes me, the 20 grand. Oh, no, you don't again. I filed appeal again. Every time I filed it, they just sent it back. They quashed it, sent it back to Judge George Pagano back in the lower court. Another couple of years go by. Now we're up to 2011, December. I get a petition that Fred filed for contempt on me. Contempt of what? You're the one that's stealing from me. I file objections and they're completely ignored. I filed exceptions to Judge George Pagano's order. His order stated not only for me to discharge the note and rid the lien that he doesn't owe me anything, it also stated my escrow of $23,000 that they took from me in 2001 when I appealed that I was supposed to get back was going to go to Fred and his attorney. And where we are right now is I filed exceptions to that order. He never ruled upon it. I asked for an evidentiary hearing for proof of payment. Nothing. March 5th, 2012, now we're up to. From 1999 to 2012, here we are. All this time, all the money I've lost, everything, all the time I've lost, time with my family, time within a relationship, not being able to go anywhere, having deadlines to file, this and that. It ruined my life. He never ruled upon the exceptions or anything. So, where am I now? Okay, I receive a letter to show up in court on March 5th for a conference. Which a conference is supposed to be, you tell the judge, you dispute facts. You discuss the disputed facts of the truth. This was no conference. I go into court. Sheriffs are in there, placed at my sides. You could hear the handcuffs, okay? I was told if I don't comply and discharge the note within 10 days, I'm going to jail, me. I did absolutely nothing. They're the ones committing the crime. I said, Your Honor, you don't have jurisdiction. I didn't say it like that, I said, with all due respect, Your Honor, I don't believe you have jurisdiction in New Jersey to lift a lien in another county, in another state. And there's no complaint filed. There's not even a complaint on the record. And there's no proof that this man ever paid me. He did not pay me. Ask him. And you could hear it on the audios. I'm begging him to ask him. Every time I open my mouth to either say you don't have jurisdiction or ask for proof of payment, he would repeatedly threaten me with jail if I didn't comply on the 10th day. Meantime, I've made an agreement with Fred's attorney, James Kelly. If you bring a quick claim deed for Fred to sign off of my Pennsylvania home, I will release him of anything he owes me. But I want my money back that gave him credit for putting money into my home, which he never did. He says to me, okay. We met at the courthouse on the 9th day. He gets a pen, he wants me to sign. I said, wait a minute, where's the quick claim deed? He just threw everything up in the air, slammed his briefcase shut, and did not have a quick claim deed with him. And I said, Jim, if you sign a promissory note that Fred will have this quick claim deed signed to bring back to Judge Pagano tomorrow, I'll sign the discharge, but sign a promissory note that you're going to bring it back tomorrow so I have this to show Judge Pagano. Slammed his briefcase shut, took a hissy fit in the middle of the floor and ran. So, 10th day, March 15th, show up in court. And the judge knew what happened because I faxed the chambers as soon as I got home. He forced me with the sheriffs again. If I did not sign the discharge, I was going to jail. And because at this point my daughter was on medication in Florida, you know, for panic attacks, thinking her mommy was going to jail, I had no choice. Meantime, he did bring up the fact for Fred to sign a quitclaim deed off of my property. So where I am right now is it's going to cost me about $4,000 to get his name off of my house when Fred's never put a dime into my home. Then, during my research on escrow, I found that the Delaware County Courthouse has been under investigation, and I found a report, which I have in my bag here, February 25th, 2010, that they owed over $336,000 in unclaimed bail bonds and escrow. They were found liable for it, and I have the report with me. In the meantime, right now I filed a petition for an accounting of my escrow funds. I want to know where my money is. James Kelly, Fred's attorney, has filed to block that petition. My question is why? Why would you want to block me finding out where my money is? My guess is it's all split up between all of them. Mm-hmm. That's what I feel. And that's all I have to say.